Evan.
William.
Thank you so much. Evan has joined my support. That was way too much.
What was it?
Jesus.
Sorry. Oh, sorry.
That is disgusting. Oh, that's actually disgusting. Do you say? Oh, God. Okay. Actually, I need to wipe it off.
Is it off?
Evan, you only need like a dime.
Sorry, that's what I thought I did.
No, it literally, that is like aloe vera. Oh, my God.
So this thing squirts too much, yeah?
It's all over the floor. I need to wipe. Devin, that was really... Are you kidding?
No, I'm so sorry.
Devin!
Hey, William.
Welcome to my support bubble. Yay! The UK, of course, has changed its social distancing rules. You can have guests in the house. But, like, we kind of supersede that because Devin actually joined our support bubble because you live locally, you're single, and so, like, yeah, it was fair. So here we are. Hi.
It's been tough being single.
Welcome to the family, girl. In any case, the Eurovision movie is out and Dan Stevens has been making lots and lots of headlines. Rawr! The Lion of Love.
Alexander Lemtov, right?
Oh, yes, honey. From Chechnya with love, from Russia with love. He really kills it in this movie. Should we watch Lion of Love and react?
Let's do this!
Wow. I love that Savannah. Very Ray Lee. Wild Norway.
It is, actually. Ooh. Very George Michael hair.
Very Mufasa in the background.
Yeah.
Yes. I love how Lars and Sigrid are like, whoa!
They're like, we're coming right after this one.
Ooh, oh, the legs! It's should remind you of Friday night. Pre-game.
It is so homoerotic. It's unbelievable, yeah. Isn't it?
This lion is busy.
I'll be the king you wanted. You'll be the queen I need.
Oh, I love that.
You'll be the queen I need.
He needs more of a king, you know what I'm saying?
Wow. Ain't no rent up in here. Oh, wow.
I love this extended analogy. The whips, the savannah.
Oh! Oh!
Dan Stevens is very good at this.
For COVID times, this is phenomenal.
We've not seen people so close in months.
I know.
The choreography's oh, the gazelle. Oh! Lifting. Oh! Chest reveal, very Moderna. Spades 2015. The stage looks so, so dare to dream.
It does.
They did a good job.
Very scant.
You know, the LED is simple but quite effective. Yeleni Cuego. Oh, is he going back in the leg? I swear I did that in Joe Wicks video recently.
Another wing. You'll be the
queen I need. This song is hilarious.
Change.
The thing is, this is very believable as a Eurovision movie, isn't it?
Who dubs his voice?
It's on Spotify, but I can't remember. Oh, yes. On the ground like an animal.
Oh, my God.
So
well,
it's good.
When he does that, it's almost like, you know, he's responding to an insurgent.
Listen, I think of all the songs in the movie, this is one of the two most believable. Like, that could be from Russia. It's camp, it's OTT, it's got a hint of Schlager. Doesn't that sound like a real song to you?
Inspired by Philip Kirkorov. But it's very low budget for me. You know, if this is meant to be like the wow piece, like, you know, they're standing in the wings and thinking, oh my God, we're coming after that.
Yeah.
It's actually quite muted. Well, there's like, you know, an Impala in the background and some sort of African-inspired savannah. It's actually quite tame. Seeing it again, it's actually more disappointing.
I'm sorry, do you remember Iceland Svala? There was less going on stage with her. Do you remember?
Oh, and what happened to that?
Tijana Dapčević, who we love from Serbia. No staging there.
My dear.
Former Yugoslav Republic of Macedonia, actually North Macedonia now.
Do you know?
Jana Brčeska staging. Like, lots of...
I like the examples you're bringing.
Yeah, I could go
those
on
are the examples.
Michael Rice, of the UK 2019.
Oh, bigger than everybody on the planet.
He made the final.
He automatically qualified. These are examples of songs that didn't get anywhere. I'm sorry.
But they were also good songs. So what I'm saying is, when you compare this to those, great songs, they had minimal staging. This has staging. I think this is relatively expensive. It's relatively expensive. Relatively.
There's nothing.
I'm sorry, but Dana Stevens slaying that stage. You can at least agree on that.
Listen.
You are such a negative Nancy.
Okay. Oh, I thought it was Nelly last week. You know what? I'm over it. I am literally over it. I get it. You're in the film, so you're excited.
No. I'm not in this scene. I'm not in this song.
Oh, well, you know
I don't know Dan Stevens. All I know is that entertainment.
We gotta resuscitate that cutting room floor. Whatever was put on that cutting room floor, we gotta piece it together right now.
You are lame.
Because, like,
okay,
honestly.
What would you give that? What is your Wee Wee Jury score out of 10?
Okay, that's a really
out
good
a
question.
10.
Out of a 10, I'm gonna give it a 6.
Well, for you, actually, that's respectable.
With reservation.
No, that's respectable for you, because your average score is like a 2 normally.
William, you're so bad.
No,
you think my movie jury scores are low?
Yes.
Oh my god.
Yes.
I'll give it a 6. I mean, it's memorable, it's fun, it's catchy. There are bits of it that I'm just like, woof.
Well, see, it's hitting you in the right spot.
Hitting me!
Let's just say your Savannah has a geyser that is going to explode. Now listen, I love the extended analogy here. The gazelle on the Savannah, I will make you rise somewhere. Someone tonight will feel the lion of love. That's hot.
What I find disappointing is Americans usually amp the volume. You know, you're inspired by Philip Kirkorov here. I mean, I expect it to be bigger than us.
You know, this was bigger than us. The dancers, let's just say Demi Swan was poking his neck through his legs.
Philip Kirkorov's shows are way out of the water. They blow everything out of the water. And this is just like, nothing to lie to me.
Okay, we're just going to have to agree to disagree. In any case, that's what we think. What do you think? Was Lion of Love a real moment for you in the Eurovision movie? Are you looping the song on Spotify? Let us know here on Weeby Vlogs.
By the way, this one didn't chart, did it?
No.
There we go. So you know what? Keeping it real. Follow us on multiple social media platforms.
Whoa, hold up. Let me just say, I don't think this necessarily works as a mainstream hit, but I think in a Eurovision movie, it feels very organic with the stage show and the song.
You know what?
There's a difference.
You should write the press release of all the rejected entries that have ever gone into every national selection. You'll always find, you know, some narrative to pad it out. But actually,
my narrative always matches my score.
You know what? I'm sorry. This is fraudulent. Follow us on TikTok. We're on there.
We have 2 or 3 videos on TikTok, and we hope to learn how to use that stuff very soon. In any case, we'll see you later.
Bye!